Netanyahu's.
Shalom, Benjamin Netanyahu, Salam Aleikum, Mahmoud Abbas. Today, here and now, I have to tell you that I have been asked again by Israeli and Palestinian daughters, mothers and grandmothers to talk to the two of you. But this time, it was 20,123 people, and mainly Israeli, also Israeli soldiers and men of all ages. That is why, here and now and today, I address mainly you, Benjamin Netanyahu. I should tell you, as the father of the nation, that you have embarrassed all Israel by the regulation bill. I know that you have got lots of credentials, awards, and you have been a great special forces. But I also do know that your family suffered great losses, like mine and many others. But for the sake of the children, we have to look forward to an honorable solution, not to one for which we and our children and grandchildren will be blamed for the rest of our days. What would Jonathan do? In the past, so many things happened on both sides. We all suffered. We cannot change the past anymore, but we can change the future. I think people on both sides have suffered enough. As I said before, Israelis from all over the world do not want to live in Israel anymore because of the conflict. They say it is a legalized act of theft, and they feel ashamed of you, because the whole world looks on Israel like on thieves. But you really want to make history as the one and only president of Israel that did not respect and ignored the wishes of its own people, not only the 10,635, but also the 20,123 people do not want any disputes anymore. A one and only state will always be new basis for conflicts. If your own people want a two-state solution and can respect the other side, why don't you do the same? Those living in Israel want to leave the country because of the conflict. Only a bunch of radicals really like the idea of new settlements by land grab. But as a president with an honorable past, do you really want to invite criminals and radicals to West Bank? Because there are already Israeli guys who boast by saying, well, if Bibi can commit an international crime by legalizing land grab, then we can do what we want in Israel and West Bank too. Those 20,123 people, mainly Israeli, your own people, kindly ask you, their president, to think it over once more. They want an Israel they can be proud of again. They want to have back their Bibi, a president they can be proud of again. From the bottom of my heart, Herr Tomari Tulsi, Ambassador for Peace 2014 and 2016. Excuse me my very personal words, but for your people, it is also a very personal issue. Thank you very much and have a great evening.